Hey guys, what's up? Welcome back to the channel. It's Cynic Alex, and today I want to talk about something that I originally promised to do about 7 months ago when the X-Men first came to Marvel Future Fight. It was a glorious day when I got my pride and joy Wolverine added, and I originally said I would get his combat power and his rank to number one. Unfortunately, I never got as close as even the top 10 for various reasons, most of which had to do with the way I was gearing my character. Then we had the changes to the gear setups in terms of having the stats automatically chosen, and kind of time went by and I focused on other aspects of the game. His uniform came out, I didn't like it at first, and then I made a bet very recently with a fan on the live stream about tier 2ing Gamora if I couldn't get my Wolverine up to rank 100 by a certain date or by a certain amount of time. So the pressure was on, and about a week ago my Wolverine was around rank 500. He had fallen quite a bit. He had an obelisk with a snare immunity and a damage proc, totally different than what I have now, but I did a lot to change him and I wanted to document it for you guys for a few reasons. For one, it's because I love Wolverine and I genuinely still want rank number one, and I think I'm pretty close, but I have a couple more changes to get through. For two, if you're the type of person who likes getting rank 1 characters or who likes pushing their characters rank up and their combat power up, I can give you a few tips that I learned that I'm still learning from the combat power rankings, because it's a pretty mysterious system and it's not always intuitive or even balanced properly, so you sometimes have to cheat or in a way create a sub-optimized character in order to make their combat power go up. So the first big change that I made to Wolverine was changing his obelisk. Now, he doesn't have snare resist anymore, he doesn't have a damage proc anymore, so I'm obviously not using him for Extreme Alliance Battle Combat Hero Day. Thankfully, we got a Black Panther update with a Black Panther that can now compete. Yes, he can stand toe-to-toe with Wolverine in terms of damage output for Extreme Alliance Battle, so I can get similar scores with my Black Panther, allowing me to develop my Wolverine in a completely different way, in a more defensive way, in a more PvP-oriented way, but the best way for his combat power ranking, because a snare obelisk is very difficult to get a high CP for. Every stat, whether it's max HP, poison resist, invincibility, has a certain score associated that will go towards your combat power. Of course, 5 seconds of invincibility would be better than 4 seconds for my combat power, so that's somewhere that I can improve the obelisk on. And 29% is close, it's 30% is the max for max HP, I believe. So I could have rolled a double 30%, so I am definitely missing it, but max HP is one of the highest statted stats, or one of the highest combat power giving stats of obelisks. So having an obelisk with something like dodge, having a simple obelisk with something like max HP, or I believe ignore dodge, is also very good for combat power, but it was just better than snare resist overall, and I wanted to make that big change, and that actually jumped his combat power up a lot. The second thing that I did to bump up his combat power, because he already has fully amplified 5-6 star Uru, so there's nothing I can do there, was for his uniform, and I've been slowly working on his uniform, but I made 2 really huge changes. I was able to mythic Red Hulk's uniform, taking it from legendary to mythic. That added 2,000 points to my CP, my combat power, so if you are looking to get that last bit of combat power to push into the top 10, into the top 5, whatever, if there's an event on for combat, for character ranking for a specific hero, and you want to get into a higher bracket of score so you can get better rewards back when it finishes, upgrading the optional uniforms is one of the easiest and fastest ways, because each upgrade, any uniform, taking it from any rank, whether it's normal to advanced or heroic to legendary or legendary to mythic, will give you 2,000 combat points. So that was the first big shift for me. The second big shift was actually re-rolling this option. For whatever reason, HP gives more combat power to your character as a uniform option than ignore defense does. I know it doesn't really make sense, but that's the way it is. So I originally had ignore defense, I re-rolled it to HP, and I saw a massive spike in my combat power. Curiously enough, the first uniform option, which is dodge, attack speed, these ones actually offers no difference in combat power. I tested it on the live stream and there's essentially no difference in whether you have 1091 dodge or 1091 attack speed. It adds the exact same amount or extremely similar amount to his combat power, so much so that you should go for the ideal stat rather than going for a different stat. But for HP at least, it's honestly better to do that, even if your character needs skill cooldown or attack speed or ignore defense, if you're specifically going for combat power. If you want to make the best character, then of course, go for the stat that your character needs the most. If you need to cap skill cooldown, that's much more important for your character's skill rotation than a bit more HP. But in my case, I don't need to cap skill cooldown or ignore defense. Neither of those stats are super priority for me because I have all of those stats already on cards and my alliance bonus. So I have the luxury of being able to roll HP, and I'm glad that I got such a high roll to 2033 being the max. And I'm also lucky that HP is the highest combat power giving item or stat for that gear option. But I still have a ways to go. As I said, I'm about rank 139 right now, so I still have a lot of ranks to jump. But if you actually look at the combat power gap, it's extremely small. So I'm at 251.45 overall, and if you go to the number one Wolverine right now, as soon as I find him down this list of tier 2s, he's at 260.915. So there's less than 6,000 points, or just over 6,000 points gap between rank 139 and rank 1. Not even, sorry, about 9,200. My math is really bad, I know. But less than 10,000 combat points separate me and first place. So if you take a look at his uniform options that I was just showing you, I still have two that are at heroic. So I technically, with Winter Soldier, Civil War, and Iron Man, I have another 8,000 CP just waiting untapped. So that's gonna bring me so close to first place, because I'm at that gap of 9,000 and change, and 8,000 is just waiting for me here. So I definitely have to mythic, as much as I might not want to, these last two uniforms. The only good part is the Winter Soldier one applies for Black Panther's last gear option for physical attack. So it does double duty for me, and it will give me an additional kind of bonus. Where is Black Panther's uniform? It'll give me an additional bonus for that one that will help me for Extreme Alliance Battle. So that is what I've done for Wolverine and what I still have to do. I've got the fully awakened Ice Weight set, so I don't have to worry about that. I'm thinking of trying to reroll another obelisk that's even more perfect than this one, but I'm not sure if I should. This is kind of the ideal PvP obelisk, aside from the invincibility and the second max HP being lower than the max. But it's a pretty fun experience, and it's one of the things that I still appreciate the most about Marvel Future Fight. The ability to highly customize your favorite characters and to watch their power just grow to this massive behemoth in the sky, and it becomes this kind of pillar of your effort, and it shows all of the hard work that you've done and put into the character. And on top of being on your account, in the case of people that are in the top 50 and especially the top 10 for any one character, everyone else who plays the game gets to look at and gets to see your hard work come to fruition. So I do really still appreciate and have and take a great deal of enjoyment out of this character ranking. Let me know what you guys think of Wolverine and my character ranking. If you have a higher ranked Wolverine, get at me. Let me know what you're doing. And finally, I want to leave you with just something funny that you can do with a very high HP Wolverine. I've got 56,000 native HP without any HP on my card, so there's definitely a long way it can go from here. But just with his own HP and just with a few help from his X-Men buddies, I can actually take down Apocalypse without even attacking. So I hope you guys enjoy this. It's been done before with Infinity Thanos. It's called the No Attacking Strikers Only Clear. It's not that difficult for Wolverine, especially when you have this much HP, but there's really only two places where this much HP is going to be usable. It's going to be usable in PvP modes like Alliance Conquest and Alliance Tournament and Timeline Battle, and then it's going to be used for funny things like this, where you just stand there, you can go grab a coffee, and when you come back, World Boss is finished. So I've essentially found an extra way or an extra opportunity to autoplay a part of Marvel Future Fight that you didn't think there was autoplay for, which is pretty neat. Let me know what you guys think of Wolverine and the combat power ranking system and how certain stats are kind of overvalued despite the fact that they might not be the best one for the character. It also applies for things like Uru, where energy defense gives more of a stat boost than something like dodge, even though no one is going to want to put energy defense, and HP gives more than certain attack Uru, which also doesn't really make sense to me, but okay. Subscribe if you enjoy the content and you want to support me, and of course, if you like what you see, I hope to see you again tomorrow. Take care.